out there in Venezuela, guess what? They have uproars of the people, man. Their economy is in shambles. Like it says in 2nd Esther, the 9th chapter. There should be earthquakes and uproars of the people. Diverse earthquakes, Matthew the 24th chapter, Luke 19, and the uproars of the people. Right now out there, their economy is so much in shambles in Venezuela. They're out there eating dogs, man, eating their own pets. They're eating dogs and they can catch the damn cat. They're cooking up cats, man. Like out there in Vietnam or something. Out there in Cambodia or something, man. They're turning household pets into meals. That's how much the economy in Venezuela is messed up right now. Back in 2010 to 11, in 2011, you had the Occupy Wall Street protest. That was damn near like year long. And down in every major city, you had pretty much a whole bunch of college students, and a whole bunch of anarchists, and what's the other group where they wear the little masks? Anonymous. Yeah, anonymous motherfuckers and all that, man. You got a group of people in society today that are primarily weedies. Some, it's a few that are Gadites, Issacharites, maybe Ephraimites and all that. But they're predominantly weedies. They're predominantly Benjamin and Levi. And they got a group called Anarchy. They wear like a punk rocker looking type clothes. They have like an A on the back of their little vest or whatever, or a jacket. It's like an A within a circle. It's not usually red and all that. And they talk about how the government is wicked. They want to take the government down because they hate how unfair the government is. That's Jake right there. They understand and they know about martial law's impending real soon. So they're like, the hell with that. Even when the economy crashes, we're going to go all out war with the government. That's what those anarchists say. You, of course, got anonymous that push the government on blast all the time. And then you had like a whole bunch of bums out there during the Occupy Wall Street protest that were protesting as well, too. And of course, the college students. They would go to every major downtown city and they would camp out overnight. Or if there was like a ordinance that was passed, they'll go out there for a good number of hours and then they'll go ahead and go home and come back the next day and do that, man. Out there in LA, they were in downtown LA in front of, I think, the major court building down there on First Street. That big ass courtyard in front of the court building, man. And guess what? For like months, you had nothing but a bunch of motherfuckers with tents out there, man. You know, it was like a tent city or whatever. You had homeless people. You had people that were college students that dropped out of college. They couldn't afford it no more. They realized the system is rigged and it's jacked up. You got to be part of some type of damn fraternity or sorority to really have a come up in a society like that. You know, you had a bunch of those anarchists and et cetera. And they were doing that Occupy Wall Street protest crap. They'll go to sleep in the park in their little tents. And they will come out and they'll go ahead and you know that's a joke, man. Anyway, they'll go ahead and they'll come out with their signs and they'll wave their signs in front of like the government court building or certain corporations in downtown LA or wherever they were at. You know, that's uproars of the people right there. Now they cut down on that at the end of 2000. They say, hey, man, y'all got to stop that. They started putting like a curfew all over in all the major cities where they were doing that shit at. So therefore, they put an end temporarily for that Occupy Wall Street. But they were mad because you had the 1%, and they were saying that the rest was based on the 99%. The 1% were the people over there on Wall Street, the rich business interest men, a lot of those Jewish bankers, the so-called Jew bankers and all that, man. So that was the uproar of the people. And everybody is realizing more and more and more how screwed up America is and what it really does. It steals money, it launders money from drugs, all kind of illegal activities, man. Okay, they work with a pedophile child sexual ring circuit throughout the states and in other countries. Okay, they do a lot of wicked, underhand, under the table, sick, twisted things that deal with Satanism, really, when you get down to it. So they started going and protest against it, man. All right, continue.
And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith, whereby ye have believed, shall be preserved from the said perils.
That's right, because guess what? Your faith is tied hand-in-hand with your works. That just don't mean that, okay, look, I got faith, I can commit any sin and God forgives me. Like, they tried to read that scripture in Romans, the 6th chapter, but they don't read the next verse to that scripture no matter. All right? Your works is basically you keeping the commandments. And as long as you keep those commandments, that's showing your faith in the Most High. You got faith that, okay, if I keep doing this, I'm going to be saved. That's your receipt of faith right there, by you committing to those works, which is keeping the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of your ability. The ones you can't keep. But we know we can't keep all of the commandments in society. A lot of the food that we eat are defiled, and we don't even know it, man. We do know about the GMOs and the steroids, the hormones, and all the other crap they put inside the meats in America, how they're cloned. They're defiled by just by the fact they're cloned. Cat Williams put that out there in a stand-up comedy before. He said, man, they done cloned the meat now. All the meat we eat now is basically cloned meat. And he was telling the damn truth. He was totally honest about that, man. They put out articles way before that, probably like a few years before, 2010, 2008, probably a little before that, how they were already cloning meat and all that. You know, Cat Williams, he's a comedian, you're still bringing out facts like a lot of comedians do. That's the greatest part of humor, is that it's factual predominantly. Sometimes they kind of over-exaggerate. But he said, man, hey, he said, keep on feeding your daughter that damn clone meat. Yeah. And little Shanika was growing that board out of her head and start, ah! You know? That's the type of food that's being pushed out in society. So there's a lot of twisted things that's going on here in America right now. But we know that we're backed by our works and our faith to keep on committed, being committed to these works. The Lord will save us for that.
So go ahead. Shall be preserved from the said perils.
They abandoned.
Yeah, the said perils. You got what's coming to America by the prophecy and around the world in other countries. You got martial law. You got rioting. You got racial riots. You got civil riots. You got free-for-all riots that are coming. You got disease, biological warfare, where it's natural, whether it's unnatural, where it's created and manufactured in a government, military laboratory in secret, to be released upon the population, like the movie, like the zombie movie, like what's that movie? It's a movie, I think it was called a pandemic or epidemic or something like that. It was a couple of movies that showed you that from the 80s, 90s, all the way to the 2000s. You know, name a few of them.
Yeah, last year I watched one of those movies in biology class.
Yeah.
And it is basically like, it basically showed that they made that, what's that African disease?
Ebola or something like that.
They basically showed that the government made Ebola, but they just called it something different.
It's called it something different, yep. I forget the name of the damn movie, but it was spreading, and really they found out that the government was the one that had released it upon the population to kill the people off. But that's the agenda of these elite Jewish so-called Jew bankers, man. These fake Jews pursuing Revelation 3 and 9 in Ezekiel the 36th chapter, all right? They wanted to go ahead and wipe out a great number of the world's population and leave out like, I think 25% or 20% or even less than that or some shit like that, as it says in the Georgia Guidestones. So they want to go ahead in their attempt to get rid of all Israelites. They want to get the Israelites that look like me or the Judite guys passing by, Israelites like this brother right here, of this lighter shade and complexion. But they know among people that have an appearance like them, or light skin like those so-called fake Jews, they know that it's Israel among them. So they're like, shit, we got to get rid of them, man. We already know a lot of them Irish niggas are really niggas in disguise. We know a lot of them Italian niggas are niggas in disguise. Oh, for sure, them goddamn Sicilians. That's why they got nappy-ass hair out there in Sicily. So they're going to go ahead and do that rural human depopulation. And the ultimate goal is by using thermonuclear destruction, man. And the Bible is known as Armageddon, but they call it in popular society World War III, the Third World War, okay?
In that movie, you know, they wanted to use the disease as a weapon. And, like, it accidentally, like, broke out, like, somewhere in America.
Yeah.
And then they said... The doctors were like trying to find a cure, but the government like basically didn't want them to find a cure because then that'd be like a shield to that weapon.
Yep.
So that what they wanted to do was drop a bomb on the diseased people to just like wipe out the disease.
Yeah.
So I mean, you already know, like
they show you that in every zombie movie, man. From what's that first movie? I think it was The Night of the Living Dead, the first one when it was black and white. I think in the first one, but I know all ones after that just about damn near, especially ones that are up to date now, what they always do. When there's a zombie outbreak, they quarantine off the city, they send military troops to set up roadblocks, to block off the highways so you can't get in and you can't get out. You try to get close, they say, go back, go the other way. You don't go back, they say, you got 10 seconds or we're going to shoot. You don't go back, they light your ass up and shit, man. You know? And at the end of it, at the end of every movie, you got the people that's trying to get out the town. If somebody get out the town, they cross through some sewer system, end up on the other side of the bridge, like in West Memphis or some shit like that, you know? and guess what? Then the town is nuked. They nuked the town to get rid of all the zombies in that town. That's what's going to happen here to America, man. They got all the Israelites over as much as they could. You know, they got Israelites from Europe. They got Israelites from South America, Latin America. They got Israelites from Asia over here. They got Israelites from Africa over here. They brought Israelites from them. Even out there in India and in parts of Arabia over here. Confusion of faces. The Yemeni, a lot of them Yemen cats, the Yemen Arabs are really niggas, man. You can tell how nigga, they kind of look like Puerto Ricans with bags, you know, them Arabian bags under their eyes and shit, man. All right, you got a lot of Punjabi Israelites from the tribe of Benjamin out here in America. All right, so like the Amir Khan ass niggas and shit, man. So they over here in America to go ahead and have them wiped out when they drop the nuclear bombs. They're gonna go ahead and basically so-called quarantine off the city. They're gonna put these roadblocks up in different cities. The roadblocks to these borders over to Mexico, all throughout Canada. They're gonna nuclear nuke America, man. They're gonna nuclear bomb America, man. They're gonna bomb this place. They're gonna bomb this place completely. And that's biblical prophecy. That's within so-called conspiracy theories, and that's biblical prophecy, man. So we know it's gonna come true, it's gonna come to pass. Any more?
And shall see my salvation in my land.
The salvation, because only a few are going to be given salvation over here when the Most High makes his presentation, his return. He's going to send his son Yahweh Shai down here. They're going to come with the angels and the chariots. They're going to beam up the elect men into those ships while Babylon, America, is being nuclear wiped out. While this place is being bombarded and just blanketed with missiles. That's what's coming to America. We're going to read in a little bit the seven signs that Russia's about to go to war with America. And America's not going to win because every country is going to turn it back against America, even other European countries. The allies of Russia right now, the Arabians and Asians, China, North Korea and all that, they're already outnumbered in nuclear missile supply, Europe and America over here. So of course the European countries are going to turn it back against America, Britain and all of them, and shoot missiles over here as well too, man. All right? Yes, sir? Oh, you just going to say something?
Yeah, it says in Revelation that the beast shall hate the whore. That whore is America,
yep.
And the beast is like the United Nations, basically, like the Western society. That's not America.
The beast is the European Union and NATO, basically America and all those European countries, the elites that run those European countries, which are predominantly so-called Jews, the fake imposters, the Edomites, and the other Edomites they have in the upper tier as well, too. All right? Go ahead.
And shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning.
Yep, yes, he had made this one since he elect sanctified, which means purified, man. He made them holy from the beginning. So even if the elect do mess up, like King David slipped up and committed adultery, the Most High still got his elect back. As long as we have our hearts geared towards the Most High in sincerity, we have faith and believe in this truth. And at this end, it's going to come. As we see the signs here right now, it's adding up to biblical prophecy. When that time comes, the Most High will more than likely save us, man. All right? Just don't turn your back on the Most High. There's more?
Nah, that's pretty much it.
All right, go to 2nd Ezra, the 15th chapter.
Speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord, and cause them to be written in paper.
Right here, you see it. The brother got the Bible, I got the Bible, all right? The word prophecy, break it down into this compound, the word pro means before, beside means word, spoken. So to speak words before, they actually come to happen before they take place. The only way you could do that, has such of a capability, is by being able to deal outside the physical body, by being able to deal metaphysically. All right, you ain't supposed to do it with witchcraft, but it's even possible through witchcraft, but you're not supposed to do that according to the law. All right, so how the Most High does it with the prophets, the Most High gives signs and visions, or our brothers are put in trenches to see certain things. He gives the order to them through the angels. They'll speak in their mind, like, look, go do this, go do that, go forewarn them of this, and they go ahead and do it. Now, you got psychics and soothsayers, fortune tellers, and all that are able to do that, but they deal with it on the left hand side. they deal with negative energy from Satan. It's not from the Most High. So the Most High is going to give them their comeuppance. In other words, he's going to destroy their asses, man, lest they repent. All right? The majority of them are not. They're going to die. Because they won't repent. You got it.
And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. Fear not the imaginations against thee.
The words are faithful and true. A lot of prophets have prophesied about the Greeks and Romans coming to power, and they prophesied about the Persian Median Empire back in the book of Daniels. They all came to be true. They all came to pass. All right?
Anyway, man.
Right, thank you, brother. Anyway, man. They came to pass. So the words are all been spoken to be true and to come to pass. Go ahead.
Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity.
Incredulity. You see? I know I pronounced the word, I just gotta see it again real quick. Incredulity. Alright? Incredulity.
Of them trouble thee and speak against thee. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness.
And by the way, incredulity, it basically means unfaithfulness. That they're not believers. You got our people today, you'll tell them, look, such and such, this is going to happen, this is going to happen. The Lord's going to take this place out. And they say, I don't believe in the Bible. They say, I don't believe in God. You got some of our stupid ass people that say that dumb, retarded ass shit, man. All right? They say that simple ass shit, but it's all kind of facts and science out there. You go on to certain websites that prove the validity of the Bible, man. All right? Quick real off topic question, man. Anyway, we just talk about some off-topic shit, man. Anyway, though, that's what incredulity means, to have an unbelief, man. An unbelief, like a lot of these people that are walking up and down the street. We're talking about the Bible. They hear us mention certain key words of the Bible, but it don't trigger with them, man. But they're in their unbelief that anything is going to go down soon, that the end is going to come, and it's very nigh. They don't believe that Russia going into World War III is the last day of prophecy, the end of this world. They think they still got time left. Or if they do realize and they do comprehend it, they say, well, I'm just going to live it up like a bunch of dumbasses, man. I mean, at least if you didn't adhere to the truth, your dumbass would try to flee out of America to another country that's not going to be involved in this third world war. But y'all dumbass not going to do that. Y'all going to stay here to be nuked. That's how stupid y'all are, man. Bunch of fucking dumbasses, man. All right? You got it. Go ahead.
For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction.
The sword symbolizes death, and the modern day sword also symbolizes the gun, man. That's the most utilized tool today to kill people in society, all right? Whether it's wars in other countries, whether it's being killed in your domestic society you currently live within, like America, or like Britain, wherever, all right? Read on.
For wickedness hath exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore, saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness, which they profanely commit. Neither will I suffer them in those things.
Yep.
In which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood crieth unto me, and the souls of the just complain continually.
Yeah, that's right, man. The souls of the just, they complain continually, man. They complain continually. Because you got all this wickedness that's going on, like you just said, it has reached up to the Most High, where he said, I had enough of this shit, man. They declaring Bruce Jenner the woman of the year. That's how wicked this place has done got. Also, I said, look, I'm about done with this shit, man. There should be a rapper to take this place the hell out. You know? My children are crying to me. They're constantly complaining in spirit. They're praying this place is over. They get vexed every single day. They got to be around a goddamn lispy voice faggot in public, at a restaurant, at school, in class. Here you end up, unfortunately, having to go to the hospital like I did last year, man. Or earlier this year. It was a goddamn, they had nurses taking my blood, like, back to back, like, every fucking night, a whole bunch of hours in the day, One time a faggot came inside there and shit, man. At first I was drowsy because it woke me up like around 3-4 in the morning. I was drowsy when I looked and I realized it was a goddamn faggot trying to take my blood. I was pissed off, man. I was angry as hell. Like, what the fuck is faggot trying to take my blood for, man? They try to spit on my wound when they put the needle and try to give me AIDS or something. You know? But that's how wicked it is. You even got fucking men that want to be nurses and shit, man. Alright? I don't want to be no goddamn fucking nurse. If I work at a hospital, I'd rather just be a damn janitor than a kid. You know? Go lay down some business. Go pile some bricks. Go lay some tile on the roof. Go lay some goddamn bricks or something, man. Go work on the road. The fuck you want to be a nurse for, man? Alright? But anyway, go ahead. Read on, huh?
And therefore saith the Lord, I will surely avenge them and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them. Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter.
Now, throughout history, you have many of the prophets, especially back when we were back in Jerusalem, back in the land of Judah. All right? Back when you had the 12 apostles, the 12 disciples, and after Yahushua ascended up, after he was crucified, came back and ascended up to the spiritual realm, only to return during that time of the Lord's visitation. You know, you had the ministry still going on afterwards, to where they were going out to Israel, scattered abroad to Asia Minor at that time. They're giving them the word, giving them warning, saying, repent. The Israelite foreigners at that time, what it looked like Esau, what it looked like Blake Griffin, that were waking them up, warning them. Some of them had woke up and came into the ministry. All right. All that was being now was being done back then in that time after Yahushua ascended up to the spiritual realm. So guess what? Right about now, the same thing is going on currently right now. All right. And you about to have this culmination to where the elect is finally sealed up. Read that part again real quick.
And therefore saith the Lord, I will surely avenge them and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them.
That's right. Because you got brothers that were put to death currently in the troop right now. And back then, you had brothers that were put to death in his troop, man. When they were doing the ministry back then. You had the one prophet and disciple, Stephen, and he was stoned for telling wicked-ass niggas the truth. He was telling wicked Judites, wicked Benjamites, wicked Levites the truth. Like, y'all wicked, man. As some forefathers came out of Eve, y'all niggas being wicked. And they stoned them, man. They stoned, they killed a lot of the disciples. The Romans and a bunch of you turncoat-ass niggas. You average, wicked, stupid old niggas, man. Or including the centurions, you black cops. You got some black cops that are cool, but a lot of you niggas are a bunch of fucking Uncle Toms. Y'all wicked as goddamn could be, man.
Yeah, y'all put your house shot at that, man.
Yeah. Yeah, you wicked ass niggas, man. From civilians to wicked ass, dirty, crooked nigga cops. Like one time, right? I wasn't there. It was my mom. It was one brother, two brother, three brother, four brother. Three brothers and my sister. And my mom, she had a suspended license for a little while. But she still had to handle business, though. She had to take, you know, the kids to school. She had to go ahead and get groceries, handle business, pay bills and all that. Pick them up from school, whatever. Handle what she had to do. The cops pulled her over, and they said, we got to go ahead and take the truck, and we'll take you to jail and all that crap. And my mom started arguing with the police, you know. She was cussing them out like, no, I got to take care of my children. I don't give a damn. I got to do what I got to do. I mean, when it becomes unexpired or whatever, and when this shit is over, I'll be able to drive freely then. Let me take care of my children. They in the car, like a whole bunch of centurions. They're either a lot of them are Esau, or a lot of them confusing the faces was too. My mom was just straight, steady arguing with them, like, hell no, I gotta take care of my children and all that. So basically what happened, the damn, one of the head sergeants, the captains came out, and you had that one single black cop, man. You got that one individual black cop, the one nigga cop, man. And out of all the, after all was settled and done, they said, you know what, we're gonna go ahead and let you go because we understand where you're coming from, miss. The sergeant said, you can go ahead and go. Guess who the only one that had a goddamn problem, man, that voiceless problem? It was that fucking nigga cop, man. It was that goddamn nigga cop, man. Trying to impress his fucking white co-worker by his co-fellow cops. Like, nah, take him to jail. And my bro was pissed off at that shit. But after all that, Esau and the Wheaties were cool. They were like, hell, she got her children to take care of. But this nigga wanna say, nah, nah, go ahead and take the car and take her to jail. I don't give a damn if she got kids or not. That's how wicked you niggas are, man. That same cop is the same Satorian that crucified Yahweh Shai, like the brother said, man. You wicked stepping fetches, Uncle Tom, wicked ass niggas, man. You self-hating ass niggas, man. You piece of shit ass niggas, man. Alright? Go ahead and continue reading.
Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter.
I hate you, Uncle Tom ass niggas, man. You niggas are fucking wicked as goddamn hell. Read that again.
Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter.
And that's through your own goddamn stupidity, man. Y'all make yourselves to be led as the flock to the slaughter. Y'all don't take no goddamn forewarning.
They're susceptible to suggestions.
That's right.
Which means that's the definition for being hypnotized. It means they're highly
susceptible to suggestions. Basically, they're easily influenced, man. So the Lord made that law: follow not a multitude to do evil. And that's what Israel primarily does, man. They follow a multitude to do evil. Alright? Y'all love putting tattoos in your body as the goddamn latest trend. Y'all love putting them damn holes in your ears, like them damn Hamites and shit, man. Alright? Y'all love committing adultery. These hip-hop artists, R&B artists, pop artists make songs. I'ma take it, girl. We gonna go around the world and all that bullshit. You know, y'all indulge in that, man. Y'all boast about it, y'all brag, take it as a badge of honor to have sex with another man's woman, his wife. And when you have sex constitutes marriage. Alright? That's part of the stipulation of marriage. You pop them and you pay the father back according to the law of the Most High that we used to go by in the ancient world. But now y'all take that as a damn American pastime to commit adultery and to be homosexuals and lesbians. It's the new fad that's in among you wicked ass Israelites, man. Like the brother said, y'all are susceptible to suggestion. Y'all are easily influenced because y'all dumb, man. Y'all stupid. Alright? Continue.
I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt, but I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm.
At that time, the Lord had already brought our people out of Egypt, our forefathers, our ancestors in the time of Moses. But the Most High was talking about the new Egypt, just like we're in the new Babylon, just like we're in the new Sodom and Gomorrah, just like we're in the new Syria, which is America now. This is the new modern day Babylon. This is the new modern day Sodom and Gomorrah. This is the new modern day Egypt. Egypt was a land of captivity. The word Egypt in Greek is Egyptos. Yeah. It means bondage. America is bondage. You got a goddamn social security number. That's your slave and the ID tag number, man. All right? This is how wicked of a place America. You ain't nothing but a goddamn corporation full of slaves. When you sign an application for a job, you legally become a slave to that job, to that corporation. That's why at certain jobs, when you injure yourself, you can't sue your own job. But you signed on that application because you're a damn slave, man. Say you're not a slave when you can't leave America without a passport. You a damn slave. Say you hop on a damn train, you hop the toll booth or whatever for the train, and say you don't want a ticket by the officer when you try to give you the ticket. He tells you to sign that ticket. He gonna take your ass to jail. And by American law, it's so-called legal for him to grab you up, handcuff you with his buddies and boys, to tase your ass, to hit you with that billy club, and take you off, haul your ass off to the jail, man. To the jailhouse. So you a slave in America, man. And that's even if you're a Native American, you do that. Say, I'm a Native American, it's my land, and you hop a train to, well, do that ass to your ass too quick. That's how you know that you're a slave in this place, man. All right? Go ahead.
But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, and smite Egypt with plagues as before.
That proved right there that this talking about America, the new Egypt. It said plagues as before. The Most already took out the old Egypt. That's why it said as before. The new Egypt, America. The United States of America. To get exact. Continue.
And will destroy all the land thereof. Egypt shall mourn, and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plague and punishment that God shall bring upon it.
Yeah, it said the plagues as before. Read that part again real quick. And I'm going to go ahead and read Exodus, the 9th chapter. Go ahead.
But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, and smite Egypt with plagues as before.
This is the book of Exodus, the 9th chapter, verse 1. Then the Lord Yahweh said unto Moses, go in unto Pharaoh and tell him, thus saith the Lord, power of the Hebrews, which refers to the 12 tribes. Let my people go, that they may serve me. For if thou refuse to let them go and will hold them still, behold, the hand of the Lord Yahweh is upon the cattle which is in the field, upon the horses, upon the asses, upon the camels, upon the oxen, and upon the sheep, and there shall be a very grievous murrain. And the Lord shall sever between the cattle of Israel and the cattle of Egypt, and there shall nothing die of all that is of the children of Israel. And the Lord appointed a set time, saying, tomorrow the Lord shall do this thing in the land. And the Lord did that thing on the morrow, and all the cattle of Egypt died, but of the cattle of the children of Israel died not one. And Pharaoh sent, and behold, there was not one of the cattle of the Israelites dead. And the heart of Pharaoh was hardened. When he got proud, he got upset. He said, no, fuck that. And this man, he was like, fuck the hell, no, I don't care. I'm going to still keep him in captivity. I don't care. But his heart was hardened. He became proud and stiff-necked. But the Lord had let a demon from Satan. He let Satan send a demon, all right? He let him send a demon orb, like ghost orbs and shit. Like a little orb shot into Pharaoh in his mind. He said, fuck that. The Lord had wanted to make an example out of Pharaoh, like it says in the scriptures.
Yeah, he had to harden his heart multiple times, because if he didn't, he would have threw that white flag up, like, right away.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, if I was in the first position, I would have. I said, look, ain't not one of the animals died over there. All our animals is dead. Look, I'm done. I'm through. Hell no, I'm out of here. Let them go. But the Most High did it for a reason. Like the brothers, he just extra backed it up with, man. Okay? So verse 8, and the Lord said to Moses and unto Aaron, take you handfuls of ashes of the furnace, and let Moses sprinkle it toward the heaven in the sight of Pharaoh. And it shall become small dust in all the land of Egypt, and shall be a boil breaking forth with flames upon man and upon beast throughout all the land of Egypt. And it took ashes of the furnace and stood before Pharaoh. Moses sprinkled it up toward heaven, and it became a boil breaking forth with flames upon man and upon beast. And the magicians, which were of the Egyptians, because they dealt with the witchcraft and magic, the magicians could not stand before Moses because of the boils. Boils are those big, gigantic bumps you get on your skin. Like, you know, like you get like a boil because some bacteria had trespassed the first line of defense of your flesh, and they went down inside. Like, they call it cyst. You know, cyst, right? You got cyst. That's kind of like related to that. You got actual boils. You get boils from frogs. What's that called? You get warts and all that. You get like infirmities of the skin. You know, unsightly infirmities. That's what the Most High did to these damn Egyptians. Hell, he did to the Canaanites or the Philistines. Either one of those Hamites that were in the land of Israel, who we.